What's up, Legacy Builders? I'm Rob.
I'm Rishon.
And this is Learn, Hustle, Grow.
We help you build wealth and explore entrepreneurship so that you can leave a legacy.
She's a travel agent.
He's a realtor.
And we are debt-free entrepreneurs.
Legacy Builders, in this episode, we are talking to you about the Online Trading Academy.
Yes. When you are focused on building wealth like we are in the money community and the circles we roll in, then you hear a lot about multiple streams of income.
If you read books on the topic of building wealth, the experts say that most millionaires have anywhere from 6 to 8 streams of income.
Yeah, that is a lot. We are not quite at the 6 to 8, but we're getting there. So since we don't have any day jobs anymore, 9 to 5s, I'll say, we are doing the real estate agent for me, travel agent for her. We have stock, long-term stock, right?
Yep.
And rental properties. So that's 4.
Yep.
So we need at least 2 more streams of income.
Now, for those of you guys who do have day jobs, you can certainly count those, right? That's usually your biggest stream of income. Mm. And then your side hustles would be anything you do outside of that.
Yep. So we decided to explore stocks this time to see if maybe we can add another stream.
And when he says explore stocks, what he means is trading stocks.
Yep. We're huge on education. So before we pull any triggers, we make sure we do our research.
If you Google how to invest in the stock market, you'll find tons of resources from free blog posts and articles, all the way to books and maybe even some podcasts on the topic.
Yeah, but if you Google stock market education, then one of the first things you'll see is Online Trading Academy. They have an overwhelming presence on Google, so we check that out. Before we go any further, please like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell.
We don't want you to miss any future videos. So the first step in the process is to attend a free workshop.
Yeah, so she did the half day, and I'm not sure what she learned there. So I don't tell what they learn.
So Rob and I had a divide and conquer strategy.
Yeah, yeah.
Honestly, initially, he wasn't very excited about this whole thing.
Yeah, because I feel like, you know, a lot of people say it's gambling. I mean, and that's how I felt. But I think we say those things when we don't have any education behind it, when we don't really know what we're doing. You know, it's just like real estate. People tell me all the time, oh, real estate's not safe. It's not that, you know, and some people, it's not their thing. But I feel confident that real estate can make money. So we just had to try it. So,
yeah. So I went to the orientation alone. It was a half day session. Yeah. And during this session, they are explaining to you the fact that when the market is down and the average investor, also known as a retail investor, typically loses money.
Right.
Because our understanding of the stock market is pretty much buy and hold.
Yeah.
That's the only strategy we're trained on. Right. Well, he did share the fact that when the market is down, banks are not losing money.
Right. And he said day traders too, right?
Yeah, this wasn't focused on day trading,
Okay.
So in the half day session.
Okay.
So in the half day session, they really focus on educating you and sharing the fact that banks who are considered wholesale continue to make money even when the market is down.
Wow.
While us as individual retail investors lose money.
And that's what I need to do. I need to learn how to make money when whether it's up or down. So
yeah. It was an eye opener because it's something that you really just don't think about.
Right.
I think our understanding is that the banks are experts and that's why they make money.
Right. So then they wanted me to come in, right?
Yeah.
So they talked her into bringing me in.
So at the end of the class, they tell you if you're going to go any further in the process, it's important to bring your spouse along because you don't want, they understand how important it is to be on the same page.
Right.
So I thought this was really interesting and we should sign up for the next phase, which is a $300 class.
Yes. And that was 3 days, right?
Yes. Three-day class. And the $300 class is called Market Timing.
Right. We both could have went, but I could not make it. You know, I was working. So we divided and conquered and she went there. I went here. Even if she learns it though, I believe she could teach me. So that's how we figured it out like that instead of both of us going to the class. So.
Right. And the good thing about it was it wasn't $300 a person if you're a married couple, both parties are able to attend for $300.
Oh, wait. Well, what about the part when I had to go in? That was the day before that, right?
So the way it works is first you sign up for the $300 class.
Yeah.
And once you sign up for the $300 class, a counselor is assigned to you.
Yes.
When they introduce the counselor to you via telephone, then the counselor schedules a time for you to come in and meet with him one-on-one. And that's the time which they suggest that you bring your spouse.
Right, or one-on-two. Because we went, and then he talked to me, and he explained, he wanted to make me more comfortable. I think they do this because they want to make sure, hey, you're going to be spending money here. You're going to be using money for this market. It's going to be up and down. I need both individuals that are married on board, or married or together on board, so there's no problem if if somebody's out there spending money, right?
So how did you feel about the session we had with our counselor?
I felt good. He did like a basic little write-up, and he talked about like there if there's a gap in between a stock. So this is the gap, this is the stock, right? And he just kind of talks about, hey, if it stays in between here, it's good. You hold it. And then if it goes this way, you sell, you buy, blah, blah, blah. He kind of just kind of gave like a basic, and he's saying, hey, whether it goes up or down, eventually they'll teach you how to make money either way. But I guess he was saying, hey, you'll sell it or you'll buy it. And, It was good though. It was good. It was a good basic explanation for someone who didn't know anything. So
right. His goal was to explain the strategy as best possible, considering we are both, novice in the space.
Yeah. So, I mean, he made me feel comfortable. What else did he talk about? Oh, and he talked about the advantages. He's saying, hey, this is more of a, it's not a fast, get rich quick scheme or anything, but you can make money on a regular basis versus you have to save money and for real estate and all that stuff. So he said he wanted to show me that they had a patented strategy on how they teach their students versus you learning on your own and, videos or whatever on how to trade the market. So
yeah. And what actually pulled me in, babe, was the focus on how to protect what we've already accumulated.
Yes. Yes. And that's a big one, because we didn't really know how to do that. And he was trying to say, hey, we're going to show you how to protect your money. And if the market starts to tank, instead of waiting until it gets to 50% or whatever, it's going to be some stop losses and stuff. And you can get out early, nice and early and stuff like that, and then pick back up later on. And we're going to teach you how to do all that. So.
And I will say that I am the type of investor where I believe in the stock market to the extent that I know when it goes down, it's going to come back up.
Yeah.
So I had previously been fine with the fact that we might lose some money, because in my mind, as soon as the market goes on sale, we are in a position to buy.
Yes.
What he was saying is that a skilled investor doesn't actually wait for the market to go down.
Yeah.
They recognize the signs, make some adjustments to their portfolio, and then sit on the sidelines and wait for that opportunity to buy while at least keeping what they have in place.
Yeah, because he was saying that, if you lose like, we did back in the day, then it takes years for that stuff to come back. You don't want to wait years.
Yeah. In 2008, there were some people who were ready to retire and lost 50% of their overall portfolio.
Yeah, I know one personally. So, and that was horrible. He had like $1.5 million and he lost half of that. Not good.
Yeah.
So.
There were some people who were already retired and had to go back to work because they didn't have a strategy.
Oh, yes. It's terrible. Yeah. You gotta have those stop losses on there. So
yeah, so we were definitely sold on the idea that we needed more information. Yeah. So that meeting was step two.
Yep.
Next, we went on to the class. When we say we,
she,
me. It was a 3-day class that took place on a Thursday, Friday, and Saturday.
Yep. So the first day, was it just like orientation or something, or what was it?
Oh, you know what? Let me tell you a little bit about the class. It was, I want to say maybe 20 people or so in the class. It took place at the Online Trading Academy office in Frisco, which is a north suburb of Dallas.
What's weird to me is they say online, but she was in an actual class. So I guess maybe they do both, but depending on which package you get or whatever. But anyway.
Yeah. It is considered the Online Trading Academy because I believe that even if you don't have an office local to you, you can still participate in the classes and do everything online.
Okay.
Yeah, so the audience was pretty diverse as far as people were concerned, men and women of all ethnicities. One of the things we did have in common was pretty much everybody in our group was a novice.
Okay. I wonder if they divide the, we were talking about this and we were wondering if everyone, if they divide the novice up and the intermediate and then the pro, you know, just the expert kind of.
Yeah.
But
it would make sense if they did that because it made everybody in the class more comfortable as far as sharing their level of knowledge once they knew that, you know, pretty much nobody had done any day trading.
Right. So
now the class actually started 2 weeks after the orientation, anywhere from 2 to 2.5 weeks.
Yeah, I guess they do that. We were wondering about that too. I guess they do that because they want to make sure they build up enough people to have, so they're not doing these classes every week.
Right.
They want to build up the amount of people so they can kind of, you know, divide them based on skill level or whatever, right?
Yeah, probably. It looks to me as though they host the orientations and then they have the actual class once a month, the 3-day class.
Mm-hmm, okay.
Cool. So I mentioned earlier that the class was called Market Timing.
Yeah. They say you can't time the market, right?
Exactly.
Don't time no markets.
They say, well, that's one of the biggest mistakes you make.
Right.
Well, based on what we learned in the class, if you are attempting to time the market without an education, you are definitely gambling.
Yes. And we don't like gambling with money.
So the first day of the class was overwhelming, and it was meant to be. The goal was to expose you to all the different facets of the market, because we said that we were interested in trading stock.
Yeah.
But one of the things they go over is the fact that there's so much more than stock when it comes to trading.
So how many things can you trade?
Let's see, they talked about trading in the foreign markets, that's Forex.
Okay. Forex, okay.
They talked about trading futures, which are things like oil, corn.
Okay.
They talked about trading options.
Options, okay.
So those were just three of the strategies on top of what they offer as far as their core strategy. Which is what they have patented, right?
Okay.
So, those are three assets that you can trade in the market on top of learning their core strategy.
The core, okay. So you have to know the core first. They got to teach you. So I guess, okay. And you can't do anything without the core.
That's right.
All right. And then you move on to that sounds like a lot of separate classes to me.
Well, the 3-day focus, let's go back to that. The first day, like I said, it exposed you to all the markets. I think it was an excellent overview of the markets that are available. Because considering the fact that everyone in the class was a novice, you just may not have even conceived that you could do anything more than trade stocks.
Right. I wonder, what I wonder too is, how do you know what the difference is? That's the thing, right? So,
well, they teach you that in the class. They actually
talk
about...
Once you get into the class.
Actually in the 3-day.
Oh, okay.
They
talk
about the differences. Okay. They talk about the pluses and minuses of each asset class and getting started.
Okay.
So they talk to you about the minimum amount of money needed.
Yeah, that's what I was going
to
say.
Where you can open a trading account if you wanted to learn more than one thing to focus on.
Okay.
So they do a thorough job of going over that. Mm. And in the first day, like I said, it is kind of a fire hose. And they are making sure that you know that this is not to be done at home. As a matter of fact, babe, remember they actually had us sign something saying that we would not take the information that we learned
in these three days and
go home and try to trade.
Because, they're saying that they're not responsible, right? They're saying they didn't say you can't do it. They just said, hey, we're not responsible if you go here and jack your stuff up and you lose 40% of your money.
So that was day one.
Yeah. So if day one was a fire hose, then what was day two like?
So in day two, they actually walked through each of the asset classes and talked more in depth about the markets that were available.
Okay.
Yeah, they slowed it down a lot in day two.
Oh, good. Okay. So they talked about the money you needed and all that stuff to inside those markets and all that. Okay.
And in addition to going over the markets, that's where they began to offer their solutions.
Okay.
Right.
Like their patented solutions, you mean?
Well, the classes.
Oh, okay. They call it solutions.
Right, because if you're there, you have a problem.
Okay.
Your problem is either one, you want to increase your income or have another stream of income, which was our focus when we went in.
Right.
Or your problem is the fact that you want to protect your wealth, which we discovered was important to us too.
Yeah.
So you can have either one of those problems or you can have both.
Okay.
And if you've got a problem,
They got a solution. Yes, sir. They call them solutions.
That's right. So as you go through the book and he goes over each section, the instructor, who is, by the way, a very skilled investor.
Oh, that's what I was
gonna say. He talks about his experience and the fact that he's been investing long term. He's a former licensed broker, and he has a pretty good understanding of the market.
Okay.
At least he demonstrates his expertise throughout. You have no question regarding his skill level.
Oh, that was another thing they talked about too. They were saying that everyone there, right, had some level of expertise. If they're not actively traders in the market, then they don't even work there, right?
That's right. So, that's a good point, babe. Mm-hmm. They said that they actually review their trading accounts to make sure that they are actively trading
on
a regular basis in order to be a counselor
their money.
Or instructor at the school.
Yep. Then they know, you know, if you got the real deal, right?
So, yep.
Anyway.
So we go through the solutions, which are presented after each category.
Okay.
And then on the breaks, each of us has an opportunity to sit down one-on-one with our counselor. There were a couple of married couples in the group as well. And so they would meet with the counselor two-on-one, and the counselor would then present to you the information regarding a potential plan.
Okay. Okay. So they tell, based on the different types of markets or whatever, then what you should be in is what they were telling you. Okay.
Yeah. Based on what solution you might need.
Ah.
Yes.
Because of what you want to do.
Mm-hmm.
You want to build wealth, or you want to protect, or you want to whatever. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay.
Yeah. So then the counselor tells you what he thinks you should do.
Okay.
Then at the end of the class, they suggest that you read through the book, because they do give you a great workbook to go through.
Okay.
Now, the workbook is huge, and I was like, oh my God, we're going to learn all of this in the class?
Right.
Well, only one section is for the class. The remaining six sections
of the workbook.
This huge workbook
are
actually the explanations of the different programs and courses offered.
Oh, wow.
So it's more of a course manual, but the education content is pretty good, and you can take notes throughout the three-day course.
Right, so they make sure they hold back until you sign up for those classes, right?
Well, you aren't getting everything for free.
No,
this when you come in, right?
Okay.
So you know that when you sign up for the $300 course, that there is something bigger.
Yeah. Right.
I mean, it is a school.
Yeah.
They have physical buildings.
Yeah.
And you're paying for an education.
Right. And they let you know, hey, this is just like college, right? This is a college for the stock market, though. So it's got to be college prices.
That's right. So he says there's pricing in this book. Why don't you and Rob discuss it tonight? And tomorrow we can go further in our conversation. This is the conversation you're having with the counselor.
Right.
That was the end of day two.
Okay. After day two is when my wife came home and dropped the price sheet on me like a nuke bomb. Okay? I thought she was trying to buy a Tesla. I mentioned that, remember?
Oh, yeah.
They were, based on what they suggested for us, you know, the solutions for us, it was a couple of them. I don't know, it was two or three.
Yeah, we were presented with a solution that focused on both income and wealth building.
Yeah.
And so that would mean that you would need at least four assets that you were going to focus on in addition to the core strategy.
Right. Back to those prices. It was like four different level of pricing. And they were, extreme.
Yeah. So at this point, you are looking at a pricing that starts anywhere from $24,000 all the way up to $68,000.
Oh, wow, 68. Okay. Yeah. I thought the highest one was 53, but yeah. And that's the good thing was, I guess, if you had the money to do this, if we had the money to do this and we wanted to go all the way, you are a member for life, they were saying, right?
Right. The options they provided us with stated that once you signed up for the class, you are a member for life and could retake the classes as many times as you want.
Yeah, that's an upside. That's an upside. If you could afford something, if we could afford something like that, then the upside is, you know, you'd like to be in something for life. So after we reviewed the prices at home, then she went back for day three.
Yeah, as you guys can imagine, there were a few people who didn't return to the class on day three.
So, wait a minute, it was 20, right? How many did it end up being? Like
I want to say that two or three people fell off.
Okay.
After day two.
They still had the majority. It's a numbers game, right?
Yeah. They still had the majority of the class who was very interested.
Okay.
And on day three, we really got into the topic of options more specifically, which I was very interested in.
You mean options like stock market options?
Yeah. Trading options.
Oh, okay.
Right. So that was a big thing. One of the things we learned about trading options was that it can be used three ways. You have the wealth creation strategy. You have the wealth protection strategy, which is considered insurance.
Okay.
And then you have an income strategy around options. So okay. I was very interested in that because I felt like that one asset would help us to address
all the areas that we were concerned with.
Right?
Cool.
Now, one of the things that was quite interesting was stock trading was kind of on the back burner.
Yeah.
In this class.
Because that's what everybody does, and they don't want to talk about that, so...
Yeah.
Right.
So the stock trading was an add-on after you committed to one of the other assets and courses.
Okay. Was there any particular class or solution that they focused on? They really, was there bread and butter there or what?
So I would say the instructor leads with futures as the topic of focus.
Okay.
Yeah. So trading futures is a way to get into the market that's a different asset class than stocks, and you can get in for less money.
Okay, I thought you were going to say Forex because I've been getting spammed on Instagram
with
Forex.
So they do talk about the foreign exchange market, but they are not the multi-level marketing groups that we hear about.
Right.
Forex.
Yeah. I hope not.
Yeah, they talk about all the asset classes leading with futures.
Okay, futures, okay.
Then for foreign exchange,
yeah.
Maybe then options,
okay.
And stock is kind of...
I don't even know what a future is.
Yeah. We talked about that earlier.
No, I'm just saying. Like, I forgot already. But, you know, I need to be in the class to get some more in-depth training so I can know the background of futures, right? You said it was like oranges and stuff, right?
Yeah. So if you want to trade maybe oil.
Okay, oil.
Okay,
and
like
fruits
that.
And okay, whatever.
Yeah.
All right. Cool, cool.
Yeah. Right. So on day three... We are getting more in-depth, talking about strategies.
Okay.
They ask you to bring in a couple of symbols to review. We had homework of going, part of our homework, in addition to reviewing pricing with your spouse and the courses on day one and day two, we also had the homework of going home and review our individual 401k portfolios. Look at your... look at your stock trading symbols if you are invested in funds.
Okay.
That's another thing they talked about quite a bit was fees within the funds.
Yeah, they want, I heard you said they were looking at everybody's ticker symbol and all that and making sure you're not paying a bunch of fees with the stuff you already invested in, right?
Yeah. One of the things they share with you is that as a novice investor invested in mutual funds, you are likely paying a great deal of fees in addition to the fees that you're paying through your 401k provider.
That's no good. Okay.
Yeah. Cool. And if you have rolled your 401k out to an IRA and you have an advisor managing that, you're also paying fees.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
That's good to know.
We are self-managed, so we don't have any advisor fees.
Right.
And we shared with you guys in a previous video, Stock Investing 101, that we invest primarily in exchange-traded funds.
Yeah, ETFs.
Yeah.
And those have very little to no fees, right?
Yeah. Maybe that's a video we can do at a later date talking about ways to save money when you invest.
Okay. Cool, cool.
So at day three is the time when you need to make a decision.
Yeah.
Right, you're either going to buy and become enrolled in the class, or you're not.
Okay, you said it was people starting to buy right there on day two and three.
Yes,
right?
On day two, people started to enroll in the course.
They said, "Hey, we're burning the ships, baby. We ain't going back now."
Yeah.
Okay,
and so you know that they've started to enroll in the course because they are actually bringing in a little box that says they are a student. It's some kind of kit. I never looked inside the kit.
So they're also
carrying an Online Trading Academy bag.
Okay. Do they have bands playing in the back and everything so everybody can see?
No. And they did not cheer or ring any bells like they do at a timeshare.
Yeah, yeah. You're trying to stay away from that. Okay. But they made sure y'all saw them, though.
That's right. But it was we did see who enrolled because they didn't go home.
Okay.
So they brought their stuff in with them. But it was a very professional.
Oh, they were going to be trading that day? They were going to start learning that day?
No.
Oh, you said they didn't go home.
Wait, so the deal is once you enroll in the class, you could just leave. You didn't have to stay.
Okay, yeah.
Right? People who enrolled on day two, they didn't have to come back for day three.
They stayed with their new stuff, is what you're saying.
Right.
Okay, cool.
Okay. Right. They came
I'm
back
sure they
to
were the proud. I would have been proud.
They came back to the class and everybody was pretty excited.
Okay.
And I will say that I was excited to see so many people who were interested in furthering their financial education
yes.
and learning sure. about investing.
Okay. Cool. So by the end of day three.
So at lunchtime, on day three, I go back to meet with my counselor again. Okay. You meet with the counselor once a day.
Okay.
And I do share with the counselor that we will not be going forward.
Oh.
Yeah. And we discussed some of the reasons why not. Cost was a big factor
yeah,
for sure.
Yeah, yeah.
And we've shared with you guys that we don't charge anything that we can't pay off within 30 days.
Right.
And $24,000.
And that was on the low end.
Yeah, it's not something we would engage in as a single charge based on our current financial status.
Right. If we can't pay it off, then we'll wait. If we really, really want to do it, then we'll wait and we'll get all the money and we'll pay it and then we'll move forward. But nah.
Now, I will say that one of the things they mentioned during the course was if you were looking at doing this full time and beginning to trade as a business, compare it to starting a franchise.
Okay. Okay. So you need money up front for a franchise yourself.
Right. It costs money to start a business. And if you were going to start a franchise.
Oh, yeah. You take a loan, right?
Yeah. You take a loan out. And most of the time, it's what? Yeah. Six figures?
Yeah, so people were taking loans, you're saying.
So there is a financing option available to you.
Okay.
So if you don't want to charge it on your own credit card or you don't have a check to put down, then there's a financing option and there's a separate person who will work with you on the financing.
Okay, was it at least a low interest rate?
I did not speak with the financing contact, so I don't have the details on the interest rate.
Okay.
Yeah, because we knew we weren't going forward. I was honest with the counselor about that and told them that we were continuing to explore other options.
Okay. So you could finance, you could pay cash. Was there any other way? Was that it?
The you know what? He did mention there was a 0% for 6 months.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah. So that was the one option. But, you know, he said you have to qualify for that.
And, of course. They're probably assuming that, hey, we're going to teach you to be a badass in this, and you're going to pay that money back within
right.
a year.
Right.
If once you learn this stuff, you know.
Right.
So I'm not willing to take that gamble. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
For 24 grand.
like I said, that was the entry level package. So when I did express concern about pricing, he did share with me that you could go down to the very base level of beginning the course by purchasing the core strategy alone.
Yeah, but you know, we need more than core strategy. We need them options, right?
Yeah. Well, the way that it works is if you wanted to get started with just the core strategy, you could do so. It wouldn't be a solution.
No.
But it would get you the knowledge of their patented education. You would get that knowledge going in. And then once you took that class, you could take some time to build up the funds for another course on top of it.
Okay. Well, sorry, guys.
Yeah. We appreciated the information that was made available in the market timing course. It was an excellent overview, and I definitely wouldn't discourage anyone from exploring it for themselves. I would say this, the important thing to do anytime you go to explore an opportunity that's going to be an investment in your money is to do your due diligence, right?
Mm-hmm.
We knew before we went to the class that we had three choices, right? We could choose to do nothing. We could walk away and we don't have to decide to learn the stock market or how to invest for money.
Yeah.
We could go forward with the Online Trading Academy, or we could utilize other resources to learn the information that we needed to know and do so at a price that we were more comfortable with.
Yes. And, you know, honestly, it's like you just don't know who knows what, you know? Yeah, and they make it really attractive because it's a school, and it makes you feel confident because it's a school. So I get the appeal, you know? But there's other people out there, we believe, that can teach this stuff, and that's what we're looking into. Have you taken classes for stock market or any other side hustle?
Have you paid for your education? If so, was it worth it?
Comment below.
We want to hear from you.
See you in the next video.